Hello, everyone. Welcome to Taiwan is my home. I'm Liao Fangjie. We introduced Mr. Tiramisu in the night market, originally because his wife was homesick, so he settled down in Taiwan. You can hire his Italian cooking, had a store in night market, sold 250,000 tiramisu in 5 years. Me today. Take out, right? Simple plan, two big bucket, marching steady on the road, came to Taiwan for several years, still couldn't hold loudly. Shy expression is his style. New spoon. Thank you. Keeping cold. Okay. Test it if it's cold. In the night market, everyone calls him Mr. Tiramisu. Italian sales tiramisu always attracts customers. The best records was 600 tiramisu one day. The business is excellent. In 5 years, sold 60,000 cheese cottage and 250,000 tiramisu. Much is tiramisu without beautiful packaging, but with high quality ingredients. That's why he has so many customers. But he said the reason makes his tiramisu delicious is that you must make them with great mood. How to do that? Machi has his own way. People can imagine his process of making tiramisu. He always listens in historical and philosophic speech when he makes Italian dessert. I like philosophy. Today is about Nietzsche.Everyone in Europe cares about Nietzsche now because he predicted 100 years ago. He said 100 years later, he described how the world after 100 years will be. He predicted this world. We're living in the world that he predicted. So everyone say,How could he know this? Be happy, this lets him work like enjoying his life. But she also thinks if you treat the ingredients with intention, the food would be more delicious. If you take care of it, it tastes here. You might say with intention, right? Have intention also likes it. Sometimes I hate to make cheese cottage.Because dividing them into portions, not many today, usually 160 pieces. Previously, 300 cheese cottage a day before. Then you have to divide like this and cover the lid. Sometimes I did, but exhausted. Apart from with intention, March has a certain insistence in the process. Like the coffee for the base, he cares a lot. After all, coffee is the culture and pride of Italian.Machi doesn't use normal coffee liquor, but makes strong and rich espresso every day. He wants every box of tiramisu with his special coffee. I use mocha. This is mocha. Every Italian has this in his family. But smaller. This is, you made a lot of coffee. Mocha pop could make strong and heavy coffee, very rich. If it's not rich, the cookies would be without any taste. Try a lot of coffee bean, coffee powder, but still couldn't find the Italian taste. So when went back to Italian every time, his backpack was full of coffee. My wife doesn't like it because it's too heavy, very heavy. Have a physical training, arms training? I gave it to her. I didn't take. She's fine.The same as two kids. Coffee in their bags too. It's much his Italian humor, but it means his insistence for coffee's quality. Just like coffee powder, we try many kind, because in Taiwan, if you use Taiwan's, the price might be cheaper, and the cost is not high, but he still insists to use Italian coffee, because they're different in the quality.The same as eggs. Many people suggest me to buy some kind of eggs then the cost and price could be decreased. But he didn't want to. He just felt that especially we make tiramisu using fresh eggs, the healthy and safety are very important. When Kate studied in Italian, Mei Machi then get married 5 years ago. Kate was homesick, wanted to be back to Taiwan, so Machi decided to quit everything, came to Taiwan with wife. I came here and I learned massage. When I went back to Italy, opened a shop, have a massage there, Taiwan's massage, but Italian didn't like it. To her. My wife say you could teach French here, teach Italian. I'm French, my mom is French, my dad is Italian. So I say, okay, try to be here. I try to teach Italian and French. Told language before, wife finally works in the night market and sells tiramisu. Machi jokes, you can hide good cooking. I remember it was my birthday. I made tiramisu. That's because I made it for grandma and grandpa. They said delicious and suggest me to sell outside. I asked where can I sell. They said oh, outside would be fine. So I try, just for fun, like again, not serious. The convenience store was close to my place. I made 10 boxes of tiramisu, sold out very quickly. So they say, you don't need to teach Italian and French, just make tiramisu. What's the secret of the great taste? Machi say, there's no secret in his tiramisu. The key point is that his ingredients must be the best. My secret is I'm making tiramisu because I really want Taiwanese to like my cooking and loves to eat great food. So I don't think I don't care about the money. So maybe my coffee is great. My cream is quite enough. And the eggs are yummy. I bought the better eggs every time. So probably Taiwanese might love this kind of flavor, I think. Machi is here, blending whipped cream. His wife is busy to divide the finger cookies there and pouring some coffee just made. Kate says she still remembers the feeling when first guest came. He just put a bucket there and with a note. Just like the slip of paper and nothing else. But someone came and wanted to buy one. At that time, a little bit frightened. Once run the business, must make some people finicky. Some say your cookie is too wet or too much coffee. But in fact, in Italy, it's really wet and very moist. But some Taiwanese can't accept that. Just can't. At first, we might adjust by the customer's direction, but later he feels he can't because everyone's flavor is different. If you change by this, it would be not real tiramisu. Originally, it was just for fun, but now the elder daughter was born, Machi started to manage his tiramisu business seriously. At the beginning, Taiwan has typhoon and rain. Even when his dear went there, sometimes we told them it's too dangerous to ride motorcycle. It's raining, or no customer, or maybe very hot. But even like this, he still went out. Much has changed. His wife observed that. The education for the kids, he also did by himself. They have a daughter almost 5 years old, also a little son. Italian and Taiwanese wife conflict after marriage is on educating the kids. Like normal Taiwan, I think Taiwanese protect the children a lot, doing something for the kids, doing for them, but he trained his daughter to sleep alone since she was 1 year old. But I might stay with her before. Sometimes I slept with her on her bed squeezed together. He didn't approve of this. You must let the kids be independent. Different culture contribute to different parents. They learn to communicate with each other. Had a judgment after quarreling. Their common sense is to hope the kids can grow up free by their nature.
Nato il gatto bianco e io non ci sto più. Volevo un gatto nero.
Machi's mom playing with the grandson. Actually, it's her first time to Taiwan. Curious about Taiwan so much. Had been to Machi's working area to see him selling tiramisu. I'm very curious about this country because my son has a family and his wife has her family. I want to know the place where they live and the place where they work. I feel it's very interesting. I like the market very much. Machi's mother fell in love in Taiwan when came here, also understood why her son loves this land. The people here are more friendly. I prefer here. How to say in Mandarin, I belong here. I belong here. Night market. I'm the king. You know, like a star. If I can sell out every day, sold out every day, sold out every day, won't feel bored. In traditional night market, a foreign owner exactly distinct. No wonder Machi say, let's start in the night market. As why he loved Taiwan, the reason is simple. Just like his name, Machi. Machi means feet. Now that you are here, don't want to live anymore. Delicious! Jimmy Shou was born in America. Her father is a Taiwanese, mom is a Polack. Had been a model being trained in Canada to be a ski instructor. 18 years old now, has opened a ski school. It's a Saturday morning after New Year, the new semester starts. Chen just came back to Taiwan from Japan, a short stay for 3 days. One day, she made a recruitment. There are so many this kind of group, the course of group. So I just try a new one, the private class. The private not one by one. It means total customization from your ticket to your hotel. You could choose by yourself. I can tell you the website and some information in here. We are now in Hakubamura, also the place in Japan where we are operating. We're familiar with some hotel. If you want to cooperate with us, we'll reserve for you. The news she shared with everyone is she just opens a ski school. She is a ski instructor. Teaches in Japan. The students are from 3 years old to mothers. I want to establish a ski school. What should I do? How do I make this thing become the new one? Let people believe, why should I trust this company that is opened by an 18 years old girl? If I have a big travel agency, they will guarantee that this group is okay. So I want to do anything. Like at first through the fundraising, organizing the ski school, Chen Mingshou took the laptop around for a briefing, now took it for reporting to students' parents. When Mingshou was 16 years old, she wanted to be a ski instructor. We feel this girl is awesome and rare. With our understanding to then, or Mingshou, we are actually assured. At that time, Mingshou's first year, the most awesome part is that she even say if parents couldn't come together, still okay. Apart from being an instructor, had to take care of kids. Yes, she was 16 years old. Wang Ziling child was sent to Japan learning skiing from Chen Mingshou, always put Chen Mingshou as a model for their children to learn. When Chen was in the 5th grade of primary school, was selected by National Ski Association to be trained as a contestant in Japan. But she said she didn't want to be a contestant. G 陈明修 say she liked to go down the hills, listen the voice of wind, or listen the music, jump with the rhythm, even shot the feel of snow sports. For frisky, Chen wants to combine interests and work. She came to Quebec when she was 14, was selected to be a ski instructor. Because in there, if you pass, a 15 teenager could get the license to teach children and the beginner. Okay, stop. This time I have to go back and then you move on. My recent dream is to do this thing, to open a ski school and be a ski instructor, then train some instructor who have the same idea as mine and could share these experiences to the students. It's my dream. Chen Mingxiu is 15 years old and her height is 5 feet and 5 inches. Has a lot of dreams, be a model in 2013 at age of 15, won a model contest champion. Later, she loved writing, directing and shooting the films. This diverse development all from the background of her study. Actually, I know to be a ski instructor and opening this school are the things that I want to do, but I still have more things that I want to try. Like when I was 14 years old, I just wanted to shoot films. At that moment, also took an exam for instructor license. That time, I was interested in this, feel so much fun. I could try, then 15, 16 years old, I just tried to be a ski instructor one more often to teach skiing, then like it more and more. At first grade of primary school, her father Chen Yingguang applied for her to study at home. It also caused controversy. In the self-study circle, everyone calls Chen Yingguang godfather of self-study. They are a real self-study. That means mother is the main teacher. Chen and Dorota distinctly know that they want to give the kids. Dorota feels that she wants to teach the kids her culture. The thing that she wants to pass on her generation is very clear for her. So I feel they are very awesome and having self-study. And maybe it's more exciting, because it's special for their children. Chen Mingxiu's father was admitted to public high school, but missed the registration day, lost the eligibility. Then he studied in Edinburgh University, joined Taiwan's Lady Movement, because Drafi can leave Taiwan, so he studied in Taiwan's university, then married Widow Li. Widow Li is a Polish. She helps the kid learn mother language, join homeless activity and use the multicultural environment. After discuss with husband, decided to have the kids self-study.
Wizerunek własny żywota człowieka poczciwego ukazuje ideał życia ziemiańskiego.
When Chen Mingxiu was born in America, I started to speak Polish to her, also speaks Polish to the other kids, then let them know Poland's culture, history, geography, and literature. Really wanted to teach them the culture and language of Poland. They are living in Taiwan. Naturally, I speak Mandarin to them. We still have some activity to celebrate Taiwan's festival. Naturally, they have a different view when they see things in the world. Multilingual children, basically in learning, will be more advantageous in the long term.
Ty weź, wyjmij książki. Ty wyjmij, gdzie jest historia twoja. No, literatura wyjmij.
Nie. Widow Li was an English tutor when studied in Poland's high school. When studied in Warsaw University, went with her father, who is a space scientist, to Taiwan. Became the first one Euro Union scholarship winner of Education Ministry and Foreign Ministry in 1994. Also was the first sinology master of Taiwan local literature in Warsaw University, specialized in the works of Bai Shenyong and Huang Chenming. What is this? Bing? What is this? Need to read. Read loudly, okay?
The Home Guard was a volunteer organization set up to protect vital defense installation and watch out for any enemy infiltration.
We believe because the study of sinology in the past, plus with transnation experience of study in Taiwan, American and Finland, as well as the confidence of native culture. After becoming a mother, she has her own idea for kids' education. Not only the teacher of family, but also teaches them by using Mandarin, English and Polish. When point meets line, there will be lots of interesting story.
Look, Mount is also in Chile.
Whoa, Perry.
Perry is from Chile.
Now?
No, he's in Japan.
Jimmy Lin is the third child of her family. Widow Lee and husband spent 3 years to adopt her. Her biological parents are Taiwanese and Indonesian, officially became this family's member in 2014. Learn more to national language and culture with them. Minze asked me several times, can we have a younger sister? I thought it's too hard to be pregnant again. Then we discussed together, decided to adopt. With our love, our family sent to a homeless child. My teacher is my mom. Do you want to see what is my mom doing from day to night? Widow Lee has to take care of the kids, prepared for the class, makes the materials and housework. In kids' eyes, mom is so amazing. So Chen Mingshou decided to write, direct and shoot short film to record mom's daily life. Time for class. Hear patterns. Moon song. Do you want to see that? Okay, sing right.
I'm traveling north on a road that's a multiple of 6.
We're learning about probability. What's the probability of number? And sum it up. Through West education, Chen Mingshou has 18 years of experience in class, just like her brother and sister. The flexibility of self-study makes Chen Mingshou develop with diversification. In 2011, she represented Taiwan to enter the figure scanning competition in Thailand and won the junior team champion. Consequently, Chen wanted to start a new career in the minor, also wanted to realize her dream. When I was 14, my father has been taking me out to see the world to do some practice, then go to see everywhere. So that time my homework became less and less. Then go to some to do some practice and research and would have more time. It becomes slowly that I spend much time to invest in entrepreneurship. Then doing this job, try to learn from it. So probably the learning from textbook will become little, especially in winter. Whose turn? Mingshou. Don't push. It's broken. Walking 3 steps. When Chen Mingshou had a break at her work, came back to Taiwan, they are gathering together to play table game. Chen said now she was working in winter, doing what she wants to do. The other season, will go to another field with her father to learn writing, directing, and producing in photography school. For them, they have confidence in native culture, challenge the traditional view of study, also not fear others' opinion, create the study of multinational language and culture, accomplish a respectful and close family. Widow Lee majored in philosophy, minor in Chinese philosophy in Russia. After graduation, obtained scholarship. He studied in Zhengji University East Asian Institute in Taiwan. Moreover, he took his 3 years of hard work in viola, then joined Zhengji University Orchestra.
Здравствуйте, у микрофона в студии Виталий Самойлов. Сегодня вторник, 22 марта, или 16-й день второго месяца года обезьяны,
With fluent Russian speaking in the air, here is Taiwan's radio station. Here is the host Weida Li.
В 1917 году США стали первой страной, признавшей временное правительство России.
Be hosting the program for 6 years in order to let the audience around the world to know Taiwan through the show. Weida Li must collect much information and often discover some private attractions. For example, some basic attractions even Russian could find, but some new ones or the things happens in these years Russian might be not familiar with. So our job is to report the instant situation to them. So we recently discovered this Nishi Honganji Temple. It's just in Russia. Almost no one knew here. Originally, Taipei has a large Buddhist, also a Japanese-style Buddhist temple. Mr. Huang, excuse me. Nishi Honganji Temple now looks like this. What kind of place was here before? Actually, Nishi Honganji in 1934 was complete when it had been built. Inside there were 7 buildings. So this place was the foundation of main building. The place now we're standing above here, there was a wooden made temple of Nishi Honganji in 1934. His interview is not to watch excitement, but be careful to dig up story. From the historical and cultural levels, uncover the mystery of Nishi Honganji in Taipei. Actually, it's very interesting. This place is a fusion of the culture of the hero of Japanese rule and the dependence village culture of Republic of China's army. In here, we could see Eastern and Western architectural style all together. It's really not easy to see that. I feel Taiwanese are willing to retain their own history. It's very important. So I'm right here in Taiwan, heard a lot of stories during the era of Japanese rule or even earlier, maybe some stories about Liu Mingchuan or the Dutch in Taiwan. It's so special. Taiwan is like a place where East meets West. They engender some fantastic to each other. Weida Li feel excited about the things that has been happening in Taiwan. He looks at this beautiful island with appreciation. Taiwan actually has Chinese culture and Japanese culture. When you came to Taiwan, you might be in the center position in Asia. You could know these two different cultures. You don't have to go to Japan or China. In Taiwan, you can discover this. As a foreigner, he knew our Taiwanese culture so greatly. Firstly, it's not easy. He even puts in on the radio. Also, digest a regional history. Then use the most concise way to tell a story. Makes the audience understand easily. I think it's the most difficult. I understand. Really appreciate for your introducing. Finally, want to ask, is the clock tower now part of wood? Weida Li became interested in Mandarin when he was a student. In Russia, he majored in philosophy and minored in Chinese philosophy, had been to Shanghai at his third grade, being the exchange student for 1 year. After graduation, he obtained scholarship, then studied in Zhengji University East Asian Institute in Taiwan. Right here, I almost every day broadcast the news relative to Taiwan and China because we use Russian version news to introduce Taiwan's view, cross-strait relations or to promote which policies or what kind of situation, so it's in line with the specialty that I learned in Taiwan. In Zhengji University East Asia Institute, study in cross-strait relations about history and status. Weida Li said, after came to Taiwan, began to contact and understand Taiwan's situation. When I was in the university, Taiwan was very strange. Almost didn't know the past of Taiwan. Actually, after came to Taiwan, I just knew Taiwan is quite unique in the international community. There is hardly a case like this. It is so special. A close strait relations is a special case in the history of the world. Vitaly's Chinese ability is great, but to study difficult academy research made him suffer a lot. When passed the exam of East Asian Institute, starting to read the history of Communist Party of China, at first I could read some Mandarin, but not as fast as other Taiwanese students. I got crazy when studying until midnight, because the book was very thick, moreover two books. Always try his best to do everything. Vitaly needs to do something to ease his nervousness. Once interview a Russian musician in Taiwan aroused his enthusiasm for music when he was young. In the early years, Russia only had specialized schools for professional musicians. If people wanted to learn music, there were no schools. In Taiwan, Vitaly saw music classroom everywhere. He knew it's the place to realize his dream. Just arrived to the classroom near Zhengzhou University. I studied to ask them, and they say, we have violin, cello. I say, no, I want to learn violin. Few people want to learn violin at the beginning. So I thought in my age, this instrument, probably the tone was more suitable for me. I really enjoy listening violin. It sounds like human being's voice. Elegant sound. Its range is also wide. It can express different feelings. Spent 3 years on hardworking in violin, successfully joined Chengji's University Orchestra. Under the home of orchestra, his skill became better dramatically. 2 years ago, he joined a professional orchestra, participated in many big performances. Being a violin without any professional training, behind his performance on the stage is the innumerably unknown hard work. Because violin is heavy, heavier than violin. For left hand, this pressure might make them not flexible. If the position is not correct, so for this I practice a lot. Through this process, just practice a lot. Then attended class, practice in the orchestra and perform. I just can feel that I has developed a lot right now. Hard work makes you succeed. What's more, to move toward the dream of childhood. Vitaly never feel hard. In addition to his side, a teacher, also a good friend, helps him a lot. I've been with him to practice to the music we wanted to perform, then told him how difficult here is. If me, what would I do? Then I took him to play violin until the ensemble rehearsal. Sometimes you practice alone, has some difficulty, but on the ensemble, understand immediately, that's the meaning. Lightly touch the string. Enjoys the peaceful power of music and the happiness of life. This powerful support, Vitaly also found it in Taiwan's forest when he first went to the valley of Xindian, then decided to live there. For me, just like a Russian writer, Vladimir Nabokov, there are this kind of story in his novels. The leading role probably went through a place, took the train, and suddenly saw the distant lights. Then he got off the bus and went there, found out this place belongs to him. Just gave him a sense of belonging. Just like this situation when I got there, feel this place is very suitable for me. Maybe this place also asked me to stay here. In the landscape of Taiwan, Wei Dali found his sense of belonging, whether riding the bike on the path of neighborhood or being on the balcony, playing in front of the mountain, makes him feel very joyful. European composers and musicians wish to live in Switzerland or the south of France or in the mountain of Germany because they contact with nature directly. This let them have more inspiration in music. So I think it's great here in Taiwan. I could fulfill my dream and combine these two elements, which are very hard for me to find out. I think that's why I appreciate Taiwan so much. Wei Dali's voice is on the air, reporting the beauty of Taiwan. In Taiwan, he also fulfilled his dream of truth, goodness, and beauty. Years ago, Jason settled down in Taiwan, done lots of jobs like English teacher, but a few years ago, he had a thyroid cancer. Then he chose to stay in the mountain. This also made Jason, who has studied in Le Cordon Bleu, cook again, study to make his American bacon.
I think I'm not super, super great at any of those things. I'm just pretty good at a lot of things.
Jason, 39 years old, settled down in Taiwan for 13 years old, had been a photographer, the host of kids show, also a delicacy writer and an English teacher. He is versatile. Right now, he is a chef. But if you want to taste Jason's great cooking, you have to be far away from the city and go a long way to the mountain. Actually, when we just lived together, living near Neihu Mountain, then at that time, we lived near the main road. He couldn't sleep well. He couldn't. When he heard a sound, he told me maybe we move up to the mountain. So he rode to the mountain and found a place to live. Eva and Jason have been married nearly 8 years. He has been unable to adapt to city's noise. So the couple moved to Shiji Wuji Shan. They rent a townhouse and live in the mountain. But the inconvenience of the mountain didn't make Jason stop. Instead, let him feel ambitions. Before he came to Taiwan, Jason studied in Le Cordon Bleu, has a good cooking, used the abundant courtyard, began to make smoked bacon.
And I'm very proud because when people think of the best food city in America, they think of New York or they think of Los Angeles. But this year, maybe a month ago, the Portland, Oregon is voted the number one food city in America. So, yeah.
Portland, Oregon is Jason's hometown, born in gourmet food city. Jason say his favorite food is bacon, but in Taiwan, he always can find the ideal American bacon. Really wanted to eat bacon, so he decided to rely on himself to make the flavor of hometown.
So, the reason why I started making bacon is because originally I bought bacon at Costco, but then Taiwan, they stopped the import, the foreign bacon. I support that now, but I didn't support it then. So I thought, well, I know how to cook, so maybe I could try to make my own bacon.
Oh, hey.
Okay. First step, you need to weigh it. That's 5450 kilograms.
Fresh pork, whipping the surface of pork with condiment evenly, pouring maple syrup and covering with foil, then putting in the refrigerator to marinate for 8 days. This period, Jason has to take it out and check and massage the pork repeatedly. This step would make the sauce tasty. Massage it. Yes, really. massage. Yes. And nobody can get my recipe. What does the word mean? Recipe. No way. You invented? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I didn't invent bacon, but I control how much the sugar. I control how much the salt and the other stuff I put in. I don't keep in secret. The maple bacon you saw, there were two kinds of salt, sugar, brown sugar, the maple syrup, but how much of each one? That's a big deal. It's worthy to wait delicacy. After marinated for 8 days, the bacon has been tasty. The next step is to start smoking it. The smoker. So first to use charcoal and use the local wood. What kind of local wood? Every time I say it wrong. So acacia wood. Is that how to say? Okay, acacia wood. It's important to say this tree fell down from typhoon, so we didn't kill anything. This is everybody's favorite, maple syrup. Brown sugar. I feel Taiwanese people like a little bit sweet. My favorite is Taiwan's pig, but it's a little bit too expensive. Put the bacon into the high temperature oven, begin to smoke. The smell of acacia wood would be emitted by high temperature. Add wood incense for ingredients. It takes 4 to 5 hours for the process. Then the finished bacon is done.
Yeah, this is real work. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And the nice thing about real work is that a lot of people say that maybe they can't sleep at night. You know, like, oh, I can't sleep until 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the morning. Most likely they don't exercise or they don't do real work. If your work all day is just doing this and then no exercise, of course you can't go to sleep at night. I have no problem going to sleep at night. My head hits the pillow and probably 2 or 3 minutes later I'm asleep if I do the real kind of work every day. Yeah. So my advice to anybody who can't sleep is go work.
Jason said making bacon takes time and strength because physical labor means he has a new life.
So I came over here and like a lot of foreign people, I taught English for a bit. And then one of my coworkers, she worked for an educational company, and she thought I would be good to be on a kids show. So then I was a kids show host for a while. And then I started playing around with the cameras. And from that, I started doing my own video work.
Enter the broadcasting industry. Jason had to work from day to night. Although he had some success, the excessive tension of light made him unhealthy. Once a photographer helping to set a microphone find out his neck is much bigger than others, hurried to the hospital to check, was told he had thyroid cancer.
I think I have passion for doing the video work, and then eventually no more passion. So I had to quit, yeah. And I think this is more fun because I don't like, the worst feeling I had when I was doing video work is editing video and looking outside and it's a sunny day and I have to stay inside. That's hell for me. So my wife and I, we went a little bit crazy and we just decided that we'd move up to the mountain and try this. It's a gamble, but you know, gambling's fun.
That's the real reason to make him stay in the mountain. Almost 30 years old, have to fight to the cancer. Just admit it was a blow for him, but he had little time to be sad. Instead, he read lots of medical information, be careful of food, started to learn how to live. Actually, he had operation 4 times. Then he cooked what he needed to eat at that moment. Must be without iodine. Right? You need to eat some special diet? Yes, I need some special diet. A couple years, maybe 3 years. He needed to control the thyroid, so no iodine in the food. If you want to eat the real test cheeseburger, don't eat anything delicious maybe 1 month, and then go to have a cheeseburger. Then you will feel, oh my god, it's so good. Jason has a sense of humor, all because he has open-minded to life. The cancer lets him have more particular understanding of life. I got lucky, and for a while I was getting better. And I told one of my doctors, he arranged a lot of doctors to come to look at me. And they all listened to my case. And they voted what I should do. They showed me the books. For my age, for my condition, I should be better. The way my brain works is more scientific, is more logical. It doesn't matter if I eat vegetable or not. They just told me for my age and for my condition, I should be fine. After these many years, they are right. I'm not very suitable for Chinese medicine, I think. I think it's special that he read some relative information. Then he discussed his condition with the doctors, not only follow what doctors ask him to do. So that time he good with the doctors. How is my condition now? And the doctor discussed with him. I feel it's different from my experience before, because most Taiwanese always follow the doctor what medicine to take, only listen. What I learned from him is that we must understand our body. On the voyage of life, Jason Graves, the writer of Siren, had a treatment at Actively, church life more after recovering from the illness. Occasionally do yoga with his wife Eva, who has a yoga license. They also love surfing, even drove to Kending for 6 hours only because the wave condition was great. Perhaps this is to enjoy the feeling of living. After a whole afternoon of smoking, bacon is finally done. Jason's cooking bacon, he also made some ham. The house is full of the great smell, which is appetizing.
If you want to make your mom smile, you can give her some of our bacon because I think originally in Taiwan, people use the same wood to smoke their meat. So, what's that? Because when older people try the bacon, you can see them smile because they can, this wood has a certain taste.
Did you adjust for Taiwanese flavor?
Absolutely not. No, I make everything for my flavor.
A friend just came to visit them. She also prays for their bacon. My favorite is maple syrup bacon, a little bit sweet and a little salty. You can eat the taste of maple syrup. Is much different from other syrup or fruit or syrup. Because bacon, we chat, then we also meet Eva very often or communicate with each other. They are the honest persons. Then in their life, they have been through some problems. So they also enjoy the living and the life more purely. They like a piece of great bread, love good weather, enjoy surfing, so I think they are different from the city's people. Stay in the forest, comfortable and wonderful. Jason and Eva also created a small garden, planting fresh vegetables under the sun. Their own small bacon also started to be sold through internet. The slow pace of life makes them have more time for living. For Jason, now the most important is to live in the moment happily. Thanks for watching Taiwan is My Home. I'm Liao Fengjie. See you next time.